opportunity of knowing and communing with God, which it offers. Now, I submit to you, the glory of the Christian religion is in its revelation of God. Across the ages, I believe that thoughtful men and devout women have rejoiced in the God of their salvation, having come into the saving knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ, and have stood in awe of the power, the presence, and redeeming love of so great a God. You see, I can imagine that to be the general consensus of believers that day, on a hill, far away, at the cross, watching, waiting, witnessing this turn of events and the profound effect it would have on all there present. Kindly open your Bibles with me to the New Testament book of Luke, chapter 23, calling your attention to verses 39 through 43, New Testament, the Gospel, the book of Luke, chapter 23, calling your attention to verses 39 through 43, lest I forget Gethsemane, lest I forget thine agony, lest I forget thy love for me, lead me to Calvary. Luke chapter 23, beginning with verse 39, if you're not there yet, they say, wait for it, I'm getting there. So we're all there. Praise the Lord. Chapter 23 of the Gospel is recorded by Luke, beginning with verse 39, reading from the King James Version of the Bible, the word of our Lord reads, and one of the malefactors which were hanging railed on him, saying, if thou be Christ, save thyself and us. But the other, answering, rebuked him, saying, dost not thou fear God, seeing thou art in the same condemnation? And we indeed justly, for we receive the due reward of our deed. But this man had done nothing amiss. And he said unto Jesus, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. And Jesus said unto him, let's read together, church. Verily, verily, I say, whatever your edition is, just read like you got it, okay? Verily, verily, I say unto you, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. Amen. Our subject for this Palm Sunday, this sixth Sunday in Lent lesson is, walk the way of the cross.
Amen.
Walk the way of the cross. On a scale of 1 to 10, how complete would you say your life is? Just think about that for a moment. That's your salah moment for right now. On a scale of 1 to 10, how complete would you say your life is? Now, be honest with yourself, because only you know the deep desire of your heart. What person, job, object, or achievement would make your life more fulfilling? What mission have you dedicated yourself to? Not for man to sing your praises, but all to the glory of God, in the name of Jesus and for his sake, by the power of the Holy Ghost? Let me encourage you, my sister, my brother, whether or not you are now recognized at home or at work, whether or not you are now treated with due respect, God will honor your obedience to him for all eternity when you walk the way of the cross. Verily, I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. What hope do you know? What glad certainty assures you that of God's eternal love, of God's unchangeable love, of God's unceasing love, of God's behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according to what, according to as his work shall be. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life and may enter in through the gates into the city. The decision we make concerning Jesus is deeply personal with eternal consequences. Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. You see, church, Jesus knew immediately that one seeking soul had come to him. Somebody, hear me up in here today. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. You are going to be called on to choose at whatever age. You will have to say yes or no. And heaven or hell, here and now, today, will be in that yes or no. You can play with it if you want to. Choose to walk the way of the cross. Verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. Look at it, church. Loosed from his sins. Hallelujah. Washed from his sins. Forgiven. Restored, renewed, reconciled in the full power of God to redeem and to transform his life through faith in Jesus Christ. So I ask you again, as I have in time past, who is the beneficiary of your faith? Who's the beneficiary of your faith? Upon what is your hope built? My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest thing. I don't care how good he looks, I don't care how good he smells, I don't care how much money he got, I don't care what he drives. I dare not trust the sweetest thing, but wholly lean on Jesus' name, on Christ, the silent rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. Take an honest, straightforward look at your life. Consider your ways. What are you, where you are wrong, where you are wrong, where you are wrong? Change your directions. Walk the way of the cross. Connect with Christ. You will need his grace and power, and you need to have life centered in him. Walk the way of the cross. Connect to surrender. He is Lord, not you. He is Lord, not you. He is Lord, not you. Let us not deceive ourselves with vain thoughts of, oh Lord, I would never. The devil is a liar and the father of lies. Peter declared the same thing. Can I get a witness in here?
Amen.
Peter declared the same thing.
Amen.
Now everyone goes into the shrine, you know, that secret closet of a heart, and bends the knee to something or to someone instead of the place of Jesus, the place that has total supreme allegiance. Remember the question about how complete your life is? Do you bend your knee to what others will say? Help me, Holy Ghost. Do you look around before you act and react to public opinion? You know, everybody does it, making the decision for you. Help me, Holy Ghost. Do you bend your knee to yourself, with self-interest being your God? Is it so if your first reaction is, well, how will it affect me? Now understand, don't get it twisted. We do think on things and how it's going to affect us. But when it's not, when it's being selfish and how it's going to affect me, I got mine, you got yours, again, I'm concerned about me, myself, and mine, and that's all. There are many others, many, many other gods that we have, church. We have the God of money, position, sex, ambition, possessions, titles, fear, you name it, etc., etc., etc. But make no mistake, church, everyone chooses to bend the knee to something or someone. I pray that you choose Jesus as you walk the way of the cross. Look at it this way. This preacher, Linda Earl, believes that when you have Jesus, you have it all.
Amen.
You got it all right. You hit the lottery.
Amen.
That keeps on giving. You ain't got to buy no tickets no more. Tickets already clear. Hallelujah. Blessings and honor, glory and power, meaning, hope, purpose, life in its fullest sense, your heart's desire met and fulfilled, truth and wisdom, knowledge and understanding. You see, in Colossians chapter 2, verses 6 and 7, we are taught, as ye have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk ye in him, rooted and built up in him, and established in the faith as ye have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. You see, Jesus came into the world to carry out a definite saving mission. He knew his purpose. He accepted his mission and received his commission. Yes, I do believe Jesus came to save us from eternal death and separation from God. Yes, I believe Jesus came to bring us at last into his glory. Yes, I believe Jesus came to bring back to us the inheritance which we lost through sin. And I believe that this journey, this pilgrimage, this sabbatical was planned from the foundation of the world, a divine destination, the cross of Calvary. On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. What really happened at the cross? What does it mean for you, for me, for us today? What does Easter really mean to you? Is it really all that important? Is it just one of those emotional blue foot lows we go through from time to time? Is it much ado about nothing? Well, thank you for asking. I'm so glad you're here. I'm mighty glad that you are thinking about these things, church, because it's going to affect your eternal destiny. It's heaven or hell. Ain't no in between. It's heaven or hell. I believe that Easter helps us realize that at the cross, the three deadly enemies of humankind were confronted and defeated. The three deadly enemies of humankind being sin, death, and the devil. They were confronted and they were defeated at the cross of Calvary. And at the cross, our sins were forgiven. The penalty for sin was death, separation from God. Lord, have mercy. Jesus suffered that divinely decreed punishment on our behalf. It was divinely decreed that he would suffer the punishment on our behalf, therefore making it possible, church, for God to forgive us. Jesus had to die for God to forgive us because of our faith in him. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Forgiveness for sin that separates us from God was provided once for all by Jesus Christ on the cross of Calvary. You see, the cross is the blood. The cross is the agony. The cross is the torture. The cross is the cry, the ridicule, Lord have mercy, the thorns. The cross is the whips, the nails, the insults. The cross. When you think of the cross, what happened on the cross, at the cross, and all that it represents, think of the only thy hand I commend my spirit. Now, I was not there. I did not hear. I did not see. Oh, but I believe that love sent Jesus to the cross.
Amen.
That love held him to the cross is stronger than sin. And I believe the love that sent him is deeper than any sorrow we can ever feel. Let God comfort you even now. I believe the love that sent him is mightier than death. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish. Life is choice. Remember, you have a choice to make. Should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Thank God for Jesus Christ. I believe Jesus can take out of my heart, out of your heart, out of the human heart, everything deep and dark and malicious and contentious and divisive and undermining, corrupt, death-dealing thing that sin has put there. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I believe that Jesus can put back into my heart, into your heart, into the heart, the human heart, everything. Love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, meekness, temperance that sin took out. I believe that Jesus came to destroy the works of the devil. For it was at the cross that Satan and his power were crushed. Now don't you fool yourself. Be not deceived. Make no mistake. Do not take it lightly. Satan and his power still exist, but their fate is sealed. Judgment is already passed. And the Christ Union, hallelujah, has Christ's authority over the devil. You have been transformed from a king, from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of light, from the dominion of sin to the dominion of God. That is a fact. Every born again believer in the Lord Jesus Christ can shout and say, hallelujah! Hallelujah about. You see, I believe that God, thank you, God, in his love in Jesus, is come to do for us what we cannot do for ourselves.
Amen.
He is come to seek and to save.
Amen.
He is come to make the world over. You see, it was an old world, and he came to make it a new world. It was a tired world, and he came to give it rest. It was a sorrowing world, and he came to tell it, rejoice! Rejoice! Your redemption draweth nigh. It was a dark world, and he came to give it light. In the name of Jesus, he came to give it life. Our church, and it was a dying world. He came to give it life. It was an imprisoned world, and he came to give it liberty. It was a lost world, and he came to put it on its feet again, that would take it back to God. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts, and see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. Right on, King Jesus. No man cannot hinder me. He is Lord. He has risen from the dead, and he is Lord. Revelation chapter 12, verses 10 through 12a assures us, and I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is come salvation and strength, and the kingdom of our God and the power of Christ, for the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our God both day and night. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. Thank God for the blood of Jesus Christ. You see, I believe the peace of God is come through the faithful works of Jesus' mission. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save that which was lost. And Jesus said unto him, verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. Said the same church, walk the way of the cross. Come to Jesus just now. He will save you just now. Come to him with empty hands. You must come to him with empty hands. Anybody dare guess why you need to come here with empty hands? If you are clinging or holding on to anything, if you are trusting someone or something else, you cannot cling to the cross. It just ain't gonna happen. If, however, you come empty-handed and quit talking about your moral uprightness and your good works and your social standing and your disability, simply saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. Lord, when you come into your kingdom, remember me. I come in the name of Jesus Christ, Savior of the world. God will receive you. When he sees the blood of his son Jesus on your heart, he will receive you. Now my Bible teaches me in Romans chapter 8, verses 1 through 4. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus hath made me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law could not do, and that it was weak through the flesh, God, sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin, condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Look at it, church. The peace of God will come. You see, I believe the record is set straight. God will blot out your sin and give back to you his approval because of Jesus' finished work at Calvary. He walked the way of the cross. Jesus came to die in your place, bearing your guilt, dying your death. He died for you. He was raised for you. He saved all who trust him for forgiveness of sin. He reserves eternity in your name.
Amen.
What was that you say? Prove it? Oh, okay, okay. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told him, I go to prepare a place for you at Calvary. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. Come on, that where I am, there he may be also. I got some witness up in here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Walk the way of the cross.
Amen.
You have received the great invitation. You have been assured of salvation. Matthew chapter 6, verses 28 to 30, comes and says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke, my cross upon you, and learn of me. For I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your soul. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. Walk the way of the cross. You see, church, Linda Earle believes, as I walk the way of the cross, all that sin took out of my life, he will put it back again. Linda Earle believes, all that I was originally meant to be, by his grace, I shall become as I walk the way of the cross. I will cease from struggling. Can I get a witness? I will cease. Can anybody confess that? I will cease from struggling. I will stop worrying over a past that I cannot change. I will stop worrying over a past that I cannot change. The only thing we can change about the past is our attitude towards it. I will stop. Stop. Stop, stop, stop. I will stop worrying over a past that I cannot change. Yesterday is gone. And tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, for my sake, help me today. One day at a time. You see, I will forgive myself and let that suffice. Because he has wiped it. Actually, look at the vertical plaque of it. He has wiped it from his book of remembrances. Thank my God, you have wiped it, whatever your it is, God has wiped it from his book of remembrances, and so will I. God has forgiven me. I will forgive myself. God has forgiven you. Forgive yourself. Don't allow yourself to be burdened by this stuff. I will forgive myself. I bury the past now, today, at the foot of the cross, and I put no resurrection over it. Make it no resurrection and lay it at the foot of the cross. The past is buried. Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for helping me, for helping us walk